Are you living with a chronic knee pain? Searching for relief and considering stem cell therapy as the only hope? Hold on, let's hit pause and rethink. There are many options available to you, so take time to gather information and make a smart decision. Surely you want relief from the suffering, to get back to your daily activities pain-free, and to have those joints properly healed. But let's not rush into anything that might bring more harm than good. Let's not be influenced by persuasive marketing tactics. Let's dig deeper and choose the therapy that truly leads to a better quality of life. The most important factor to consider here is the cause of your arthritis. Is it due to aging, trauma, or overuse of your joints, some infections, or a specific medical condition like rheumatoid arthritis? Understanding the root cause is essential in determining the most effective treatment path for your condition. Moreover, addressing any causal diseases or conditions is crucial before tackling the arthritis itself. Failing to treat the primary ailment can allow the arthritis to progress unchecked, potentially worsening your symptoms and overall joint health. To understand osteoarthritis, let's take a closer look at the structure of your knee. Your knee is a complex joint that allows you to bend, straighten, and support your body weight. Knee joint is a cushioned hinge between the long bone of your thigh, the femur, and the larger bone of your lower leg, the tibia. Within this joint, there is a smooth rubbery material covering the ends of your bones where they meet. This material is called cartilage and it serves as a protective layer that allows your bones to glide smoothly against each other when you move your knee. This is a soft, flexible padding similar to the rubbery surface of a shock absorber in car. It's tough enough to withstand the pressure and friction of the movement, but it's also soft and springy, which helps absorb the impact of activities like walking, running, or jumping. The cells present in cartilage are chondrocytes, which are like the maintenance workers of your knee. These cells are nestled within a dense, gel-like substance called extracellular matrix or ECM. Chondrocytes are the mature cells responsible for maintaining the cartilage structure and function. Now let's talk about the synovial fluid, which is like the lubricating oil in the machine. It's a slippery fluid found within the joint spaces and helps reduce friction between the cartilage surfaces as the knee moves. It also provides nutrients to the cartilage cells and removes waste products, helping to maintain the health of the entire joint. In a healthy knee, these structures work together seamlessly, allowing for pain-free movement. In osteoarthritis, the cartilage in the knee joint begins to break down over time. As the cartilage wears away, the bones may rub against each other, causing pain and discomfort, especially during movement. Osteoarthritis can cause the knee joint to become stiff and difficult to move, particularly after periods of inactivity. Inflammation may occur in the joint, leading to swelling and tenderness around the knee. As the condition progresses, you may experience a decreased range of motion in your knee, making it challenging to bend or straighten your leg fully. Osteoarthritis typically progresses through several stages, each characterized by specific changes in the cartilage, bones, and synovial fluid of the affected joint. Let's explore each stage. In the early stage, there might be minor damage to the cartilage, such as thinning or softening. Small fissures or cracks may begin to develop on the surface of the cartilage. The bones underneath the cartilage may start to undergo some changes, such as mild thickening or the formation of small bony outgrowths called osteophytes. Synovial fluid production may increase slightly in response to early inflammation, but there may be minimal changes in the fluid composition. How to manage mild osteoarthritis? Lifestyle modifications, weight management, low impact exercises, and avoiding activities that increase symptoms. Strengthening exercises, stretching, and joint mobilization to improve joint function and reduce pain. Pain management, over-the-counter pain relievers such as acetaminophen or non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs can be taken to manage discomfort. Glucosamine and chondroitin sulfate may help support joint health and reduce symptoms in some individuals, but the scientific data is not available. Ointments or creams containing NSAIDs or capsaicin may produce localized pain relief. Assistive devices, braces, orthotics, or walking aids to support the affected joint and improve mobility. Moderate osteoarthritis. Cartilage loss becomes more noticeable with the larger areas of thinning and erosion. Cartilage may become roughened and uneven, leading to increased friction between the bones. As the cartilage wears away, the underlying bones may undergo further changes, including more significant thinning and the development of larger osteophytes. Inflammation in the joint may increase, leading to greater synovial fluid production and changes in the fluid composition, such as increased level of inflammatory markers. How to manage moderate osteoarthritis? Corticosteroid injections to reduce inflammation and alleviate pain in the affected joint. Hyaluronic acid injections to lubricate the joint and improve shock absorption. Injection of concentrated PRP from the patient's blood to promote tissue healing and reduce inflammation. Stem cell therapy. Injection of stem cells into the joint to stimulate tissue repair and regeneration. Arthroscopic surgery. Minimally invasive procedures to remove damaged tissue, smooth rough surfaces, or repair torn cartilage. Cartilage restoration techniques. Surgical procedures such as autologous chondrocyte implantation or ACI to repair or replace damaged cartilage. Severe osteoarthritis. Extensive loss of cartilage occurs, resulting in exposed bone surfaces within the joint. This leads to significant pain, stiffness, and reduced joint function. The bones may undergo significant remodeling and deformity due to ongoing degenerative changes. Osteophytes may become larger and the joint spaces may be severely narrowed. Inflammation and swelling in the joint may be pronounced, causing a significant increase in the synovial fluid production. The composition of the fluid may become more inflammatory, contributing to pain and stiffness. Therapies for severe osteoarthritis. total joint replacement, surgical removal of the damaged joints and replacement with the prosthetic implant. Partial joint replacement, surgical replacement of only the damaged portion of the joint with the prosthetic component. Joint fusion or arthrodesis, surgical fusion of the bones in the affected joint to eliminate motion and reduce pain. Osteotomy or realignment surgery to shift weight away from damaged areas of the joint. Cartilage tissue has limited capacity of self-healing due to several factors. Cartilage is avascular, meaning it lacks blood vessels. Blood vessels play a crucial role in delivering oxygen, nutrients, and immune cells to the tissues, which are essential for healing process. Cartilage contains chondrocytes, specialized cells responsible for maintaining extracellular matrix of cartilage. However, compared to other tissues, it has relatively low density of chondrocytes. This low cellularity limits the tissue's ability to respond to injury and to initiate healing process. The ECM of cartilage consists mainly of collagen and proteoglycans, which provide structural support and resilience to the tissue. While this composition is essential for the function of cartilage, it also presents challenges for the healing. Chondrocytes within the cartilage have limited metabolic activity and are relatively quiescent, further hindering the tissue's ability to regenerate in response to injury. Cell therapies for knee osteoarthritis. Mesenchymal stem cell therapy. Mesenchymal stem cells can differentiate into various cell types, including chondrocytes, which makes them promising for cartilage repair. MSCs can be harvested from the patient's own bone marrow, adipose, or other sources, and then injected into the knee joint to promote tissue regeneration and reduce inflammation. However, differentiation process can be influenced by various factors, including the local microenvironment and signaling molecules present in the damaged tissues. In some cases, stem cells may differentiate into fibrocartilage rather than hyaline cartilage. Fibrocartilage is structurally different from the hyaline cartilage and may not provide the same level of functionality. Efficacy can vary depending on the factors such as cell source, preparation method, and delivery techniques. Long-term outcomes and safety profiles are still being studied. Most important is many regulatory authorities have not approved it yet. Scaffold-based therapies. In scaffold-based therapies, stem cells or chondrocytes are combined with the biocompatible scaffolds that provide structural support and guidance for the tissue regeneration. These scaffolds can be implanted into the knee joint to facilitate cartilage repair and regeneration. Scaffold therapy is currently in research. Ensure that stem cell therapy you are considering has received regulatory approval or is being conducted as a part of clinical trial approved by relevant regulatory bodies such as FDA or equivalent agencies in other countries.